Hi, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this tutorial, we will talk about the cultivation process of cauliflower crop. Cauliflower has different names in different languages. In Hindi, it is popularly called gobi. The scientific name of cauliflower is Brassica oleracea variety botrytis, and the crop belongs to the family Brassicaceae. The head of a cauliflower is also called a curd. Curd is a group of tightly packed flower buds that have not fully developed. The buds are attached to fleshy stalks where most of the nutrients required for the growth are stored. The leaves surrounding the curd are ribbed and coarse green leaves that protect the crop from sunlight and impede the development of chlorophyll. And the seeds are head-shaped. Cauliflower thrives best in cool and moist climatic conditions. The cauliflower crop can withstand very low temperature too. Dry weather and low humidity is not suited for the cultivation of cauliflower crop. A temperature ranging from 10 degrees centigrade to 25 degrees centigrade is most suitable for the cultivation of cauliflower crop. Let us now see the different stages in the cultivation process of cauliflower crop. The different stages are land preparation, drip irrigation, seedlings cultivation in nursery, transplantation, weeding, pest and disease management, and harvesting. We will now see how the land is prepared for the cultivation of cauliflower crop. Let us now see how to prepare land for the cultivation of cauliflower crop. Cauliflower can be grown on a wide range of soils. However, sandy loam soil is preferred for early crops, while loam and clay loams for late crops. Soil should be rich in nutrients and organic matter. The field where the crop is being cultivated needs sufficient soil moisture with a good drainage facility. Cauliflower grows best on soil having pH range from 6.0 to 7.0. If the soil is below pH 5.5, liming at the rate of 5 to 10 quintals per hectare should be done for successful raising of cauliflower. The soil must be thoroughly prepared to make it loose and friable and retentive to moisture. The land must be ploughed deeply before planting with a disc harrow or chisel plough or other suitable equipment to a depth of 30 to 45 centimeters. Basic organic manures should be applied during the field preparation. 100 kgs nitrogen and 50 kgs phosphorus can be added to the soil to increase soil fertility. 1 to 2 corrosive ploughing by a soil turning plough followed by 3 to 4 ploughings with desi plough are enough for land preparation. Once the land preparation is complete, we have to arrange for drip irrigation to the field. Let us now see the arrangement of drip irrigation. Drip irrigation saves water and fertilizer by allowing water to drip slowly to the roots of plants, either onto the soil surface or directly into the root zone through a network of valves, pipes, tubing, and emitters. Overhead irrigation wets the plants but produces runoff. In contrast, drip irrigation is a much more controlled irrigation method. It works by exposing the roots to a direct supply of water. Drip irrigation system releases water in a slow and steady fashion, and controlled amount of water is supplied to plants at regular intervals. We will further talk about the next stage, that is the seedlings cultivation in nursery. The protrays are filled with coco peat. Coco peat is the product obtained from coconut coir and has
water holding capacity. Coco peat has high moisture retention capacity, hence there is no need for irrigation until germination. After sowing, 10 trays are kept one over the other for 3 to 6 days. On germination of seedlings, trays are shifted to net house and spread over the beds to avoid evaporation. The trays are irrigated depending on the prevailing weather using a fine sprinkling rose can or hose pipe fitted with rose. Trays are drenched with water soluble fertilizer at 12th and 20th day after sowing is practiced. This enhances the growth of the seedlings. The trays are provided with protective cover from rain by covering with polythene sheets in the form of low tunnel during rains. The seedlings are now ready for transplanting in about 25 to 30 days. The seedlings are ready in 3 to 4 weeks for transplanting when they attain a height of 12 to 15 cm with 3 to 4 leaves. Harden the seedlings by withholding irrigation. Uproot the seedlings carefully without causing injury to the roots. Let us now see the transplantation of seedlings in the irrigated field. Seedlings should be transplanted soon after they are removed from prot trays. Transplanting is done on moist soil. The soil around the roots should be firm and irrigated well before transplantation. Plant population and spacing influence the curd size, curd shape and yield of the cauliflower crop. Plant populations of 50,000 per hectare is suggested for early crop types, while for the late crop type, a population of 40,000 plants per hectare is said to be ideal. It is recommended that early crop cultivars should be planted 45 into 45 centimeters. Late crop varieties are planted 60 into 60 centimeters apart. Once the transplantation is over, irrigation is to be done immediately. Thereafter, irrigation should be applied at intervals of 4 to 5 days in heavy soils or 3 days in light soils, and the schedule should be followed until the curds are fully developed and firm. Young plants should receive enough water for vegetative growth before forming curds. Let us now understand the weeding practices that are required in the field. To kill the early weeds, manual weeding is done by hoe or khurpi. Doing deep weeding inside the soil with khurpi is not suggested because this may disturb the cauliflower roots. So, careful weeding and intercultural operations are necessary. Once the crop starts growing, attacks by pests and diseases become major problems. Let us now understand pest and disease management in the cultivation process of cauliflower crop. Cauliflower crops can be attacked by pests such as diamond back moths, leaf webbers, stem borers, tobacco caterpillars, aphids, and painted bugs. The major diseases that can attack the crop are club root, leaf spot, leaf blight, and blanching. The attacks by diamond back moth can be controlled by spraying pesticide quinalfos. Spraying of pesticide chloripyrifos can control the attacks by leaf webber. To control the pest attack by stem borers, pesticide chloripyrifos can be sprayed. Tobacco caterpillars can be controlled by spraying pesticide neem oil. To control the attacks by aphids, pesticide dimethoate can be sprayed. Painted bug can be controlled by spraying pesticide dimethoate. The club root disease can be controlled by spraying fungicide carbendazim. Fungicide mancozeb can be sprayed to control leaf spot disease. To control the leaf blight disease, fungicide mancozeb can be sprayed. Let us now understand the harvesting practices in the cultivation process of cauliflower crop. Cauliflower should be harvested when the curd has developed to a proper size and is at the right stage of maturity. The curd should be compact, but it should not be broken into segments. The plant is cut off well below the curd so that the stub has left the head. This prevents damaging during transporting to the market. The plants are cut as and when the curds are well developed. As curds do not develop uniformly, so only those which are fully developed are removed, but not the over-matured ones. This is done after inspecting the whole field each second or third day, harvesting the field during morning or evening so that the produce may be kept cool for the market is considered the best practice. The average yield of cauliflower in case of early cauliflower crop is 200 to 250 quintals per hectare, while in case of later crop it is 250-300 quintals per hectare.
Thank you for watching our tutorial on the cultivation process of cauliflower crop. Stay connected with tutorialspoint.com to watch our next tutorials on the cultivation processes of different crops.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.